the struggle for justice, whether it's gender justice, environmental justice, social justice, is a marathon, not a sprint. Right? And the biggest contribution any one of us could make is to have the perseverance, the stamina, the staying power to continue to push until those struggles have been won. And I think that for me, just being with you all, and I just want to thank you very, very much. It's been a super inspiration to me because and similarly when I was in Chicago, Saturday with the communities living around the coal plants where we marched and so on. It's been amazingly inspirational for me because it sort of is sending a message that they're absolutely involved in it. And so long as there's, you know, a handful of people, that's all it actually takes. There was a woman called Margaret Mead who said it, you know, that she said, you know, never doubt that a small group of people can change the course of history, because indeed that's the only thing that has ever did. Right? So whenever, you know, I mean, I think, but I'll be honest with you, I also hit my down days very often, you know, when I just think, my God, you know, does it have to be so painfully slow? and when I hit that, I always think about the distinction between the math and the skin. And that just, and then also always think that the world is such a pessimistic place where it's not for people like you. And to be honest with you, and I'm not saying this just to be politically correct, but I, from the bottom of my heart, would say that as somebody who has spent most of my life as a grassroots organizer, the work that I'm doing at a global level and meeting with heads of state and telling them things that they know anyway, right? I mean, none of the meetings I participate, I'm telling the CEO or whatever, anything that they don't know. They know exactly what I'm going to say. I know exactly what they're going to tell me back in terms of justification, right?
And then you take a picture.
Yeah, you know, actually, usually they're the ones who take a picture these days now. But what I'm saying is that I think the more important contribution is the contribution of folks fighting at the local level, everywhere in the world. You know, I mean, without the fights at the local level, anything that, you know, Sierra Club does at the national level, or Greenpeace does at the international level, or without folks on the ground fighting the way I think you folks are trying to do and will do and move forward, that's, in my judgment, where the integrity and the legitimacy and the substance of what we try to do at the global level is nourished by. Without that, we would be like really, you know, not having, I think, a strong basis to say what we have to say at the United Nations climate negotiations and so on. So I'd just like to say thank you very, very much for making the time.
Sure.